Good morning. I am David, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. In this video, I am going to explain some few topics from the 5th unit of Process Planning and Cost Estimation. So this is a second video I am going to post from 5th unit. First, we can see the estimation of machining time. To estimate the cost of any product involving machining operations, the machining time is required to be estimated before the total cost of the product or component can be computed. In addition to the actual time taken for operation to be carried out, time is spent on certain other elements of work that we have to know, we have to find out. The total time required to perform a machining operation consists of the following elements, that is, setup time, handling time, machining time, tear down time, downtime, and allowances. Setup time will coming under, this is the time taken to prepare the machine for operation. It includes study the component drawing, draw tools from tool grip, and install and adjust the tools, jigs and witches on the machine. Then handling time. It is the time taken by the operator in preparing a part for machining and for disposing the part after operation has been completed. The handling time includes the time for loading and unloading the component on the machine, making measurements on parts during machining, etc. Then third one, machining time. It is a time for which the machine works on the component, that is, from the time when the tool touches the workpiece to when the tool leaves the component after completion of the operation. It is machining time. Then unit operation time. The summation of handling time and machining time for a job is called operation time. It is the duration of time that elapses between output of two consecutive units of production. Then tear down time. It is the time taken to remove tools, jigs and fixtures from the machine and clean the machine and tools after operation has been done on the last component of the batch. Then down time. It is the time wasted by the operator due to breakdowns, non-availability or delay in supply of tools and materials, etc. Then allowances. In addition to the elements of the time described above, the total time to perform an operation include a number of allowances like time for personal needs of the operator, time for checking, time for tool sharpening, etc. The various allowances are follows. First one, personal allowance. This is the time taken by the operator in attending to his personal needs and includes the time spent in going to toilet, cafeteria. It is usually taken as 5% of total time. Then fatigue, the long working hours and working conditions such as poor lighting, poor ventilation, etc. cause fatigue and affects the efficiency of the worker. That is, fatigue decreases the work capacity to work. The allowance for fatigue is taken depending upon the type of work. Now, from this unit, we can see a problem. That is, calculate the machining time to tan the dimensions shown in figure starting from a MS bar of 80 mm. The cutting speed with high speed steel tool 60 meters per minute and feed is 0.7 millimeter per revolution. Depth of cut is 2.5 mm per pass. So this is the diagram. We have to make this, we have to manufacture the component, this component. So initial diameter of the workpiece is 80 mm. We have to make two strips for the length of 50 and 50. Solution, this is cutting speed. This is feed. The tanning will be done in two steps. The first step, a length of 50 plus 50 is equal to 100 will be reduced from 80 mm diameter to 60 mm diameter, and in second step the length of 50 mm will be reduced from 60 mm diameter to 40 mm diameter. So first step we can proceed now. For turning from 80 mm diameter to 60 mm diameter, length is 100 mm. We have to find out the n value with respect to the diameter d, that is 80. N value is 240 mm. Number of passes is the capital diameter minus small diameter divided by 2 into depth of cut. So that is 4. 4 times the tool has to be passed on the workpiece. So time required, formula you know, length of cut divided by f into n into number of cuts. So 2.38 minutes. In the first step, we take 2.38 minutes to complete. Then second step, to turn the diameter 40 mm from 60 mm diameter and 50 mm long. So for now, we have to find out the n value separately with the diameter of 60 mm. We get 318 rpm. Number of passes, maximum 60 diameter, minimum 40 diameter, divided by 2 into depth of cut is 2.5, it is equal to 4. So time required for second cutting is 0.9 minute. So the total time required for complete this operation is 3.28 minutes. Thank you, students.